Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So, let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And we see that the market has recorded a small price decline or correction for the last 24 hours. That's why I would say that the consolidation continues. Some days we have these ups, some days we have these downs. So, this is why I said the prices of the major cryptocurrencies are consolidating. And today, let's analyze one of these beautiful major cryptocurrencies. I would say let's have a look at Ethereum Classic, because yesterday I read some articles about Ethereum Classic, and that's why let's have a look at the price chart of Ethereum Classic. So, this is the price chart. The current price is $53. Approximately, or $52.92. This is the daily chart. This is how it looks like. We will analyze in detail this price chart, but let's start from the monthly time frame. And we have these interesting candlesticks. First, these are, of course, bullish candlesticks with ascending local lows and ascending local highs. But the last one has a very, very tall upper shadow, indicating that all of a sudden the bears appeared, they pushed the price down, and now they are putting pressure on the price of Ethereum Classic, because we have this descending local highs and to some extent descending local lows. But the last candlestick, the last monthly candlestick, or for the previous of June, and the month has just ended, has a body that is in the upper part of this body, so it indicates that here the bulls were able to support the price and to push it up. That's why it seems that here we have support. Now, if we go to the weekly chart, I would like to highlight that this support to some extent is visible, because we have this, let's say, attempt for a bullish engulfing. So the current weekly candlestick is trying to engulf the body of this bearish candlestick. That's why it seems that this is a signal indicating that we're experiencing some support, and probably the bulls will try to support the price at the current levels. Now, if we switch to the daily chart, this is how this support looks like. I would like to mention that this support is very close to the level of this consolidation that took place in April. So let's draw a horizontal line like this. And this is actually this support. This is within the range of this consolidation. Also, if we have a look at the price chart and inspect the previous all-time high from 2017, this is the same level, or let's say range. So this is the local high from 2017. So this is this local high or range. And now it seems that the price is receiving a lot of support from that local high or from that range. And if we add, for example, the 90-day moving average here, so let me add two moving averages, of course, the 90-day moving average and the 30-day moving average, or for the period of 1 month and for the period of 3 months, 90 days. So this is the monthly. This is the 3 month moving average. So we see that at the moment, the prices at these two moving averages, and a kind of bearish signal is taking place, because it's a moving average crossover. However, let's wait and see, because first of all, these two moving averages, they act as magnet and they attract the price. Also, this range here that I have just outlined is equal to the, let's say, range of the previous local high from 2017. That's why here we will see some support, but it's really very interesting, because we have this moving average crossover taking place right now, but we have a lot of support below, slightly below the current level. Now, if we switch to the 4-hour chart, I would recommend to have a look at all these resistance lines that we even analyzed before. So this is the latest one. Let's say this is the latest one. And now it seems that the price is trying to break through this resistance line and to put an end to this, let's say, descending channels. Of course, we can adjust them a little bit, for example, like this. But my main idea is that we have to keep an eye now on the price behavior within this descending channel, testing the upper line in the 4-hour chart or testing the resistance, because if a breakout takes place, this will put an end to this descending channel or correction and probably receiving support within this range that once again I highlighted and I outlined that is the range equal to the previous local high. The price of Ethereum Classic may receive support and resume slowly but steadily the price increase. So that's why we have to keep an eye on all these technical formations. However, if the decline within these channels or channel continues, then the bears will continue to put pressure on the price and it may decline further. That's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching this video. Please share your point of view on the price of Ethereum Classic as a comment under this video. Of course, I wish you a very wonderful day. Good luck in the financial markets and hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpark.